Hey guys, it's me, JC, wishing all of you that you have a beautiful 4th of July. Wonderful country we live in, for those of us who live in the US. Canada and all the other countries have great things as well, and in Europe. But this is our day today, the 4th of July. So wishing all you guys many blessings. I'm going to show you some recent things I got. Like I said, I have time constraints and mostly space constraints, but these are some albums I got, some additions to the Elvis collection and some stuff. And today's a beautiful 4th. It's hot as heck out there. It's probably 9 degrees. I want to start with the collection. This is a British album. It's a Living Legends album. Great shape, Warwick Records. It is Living Legends, the Everly Brothers, 20 original greatest hits. And it's got all the good songs. It's got Wake Up Little Susie, Bird Dog, you know, like Strangers, All I Have to Do is Dream, Claudette. It has covers like Be Bop Luda, Keep a Knockin', Leave My Woman Alone. It has 24 songs. Great, great British pressing. It really is. It talks a little bit about him on Warwick Records. I don't know. This must be, I'm assuming, in the mid to late 70s. It says it's advertised on TV and radio. And as you can see, it has a lot of the great cars of its day. Now, moving on. This is a double album. Imported, I'm assuming, Silver Eagle. This is probably not imported. That's where Silver Eagle Records are for work. Palm Canyon, American company. They released a Royal Orbison all-time greatest hits. Now, the thing that kind of is odd is, you know, how they get the rights to these songs, but, okay, it's a double album, actually. It has Only Alone. He has all the greatest hits, Pretty Woman, Candyman. Produced and arranged by Michael Ogden, musicians Roy Orbison, Ruby Doobie, Dean Parks, all those musicians. It's a 1986 one. I never saw this before. It's two albums in here. It's not gatefold, but it does include two albums in great shape. You know, Blue Bayou is on this, Crying, you know, Running Scared, all his big hits, Lana. Great album. On Eagle Records, Silver Eagle Records, out of California. Okay, great album, and band I like. Gatefold, one single album. Then and Now of the Monkees on Arista Records. This came out, I think, in the mid-80s. Yeah, it has, of course, Theme from the Monkees, Last Train to Clarksville, Daydreams of the Year. It has Kicks, which is a great song I love, A Little Bit of Me, A Little Bit of You. I'm Not Your Stepping Stone, I love that song. I know you guys have seen the Monkees Then and Now. I love it, you know, it's a gatefold. It's really, really a labor of love for Monkees fans everywhere who enjoyed their music, you know. And the sad passing not too long ago of lead singer, British frontman Davy Jones. So, okay, this is a great album. And now, for all you guys, I am going to, I get fucking bothered by phone calls, but anyway. Now after that one, comes this one, the new original soundtrack for the motion picture Elvis. This was done by Kurt Russell. Great. Sorry about that, a little outburst. I just should have turned off the phone, which is what I'm gonna do now. I don't wanna get bugged. Okay. The Kurt Russell one is actually interesting. I'll file it under the Elvis. That's premiered on TV. Original soundtrack. I never saw the movie. I mean, I'm sure you guys have seen it. 1979, Dick Clark Motion Pictures. This is printed in Canada. This is a Canadian album. No wonder I never saw this in the U.S. Of course, Kurt Russell, we know, is all-American. And the movie has Shelley Winters and Mark Presley. And I think most Coroner Parker. Season Hub is Priscilla. Ticket producer Dick Clark. Okay, good album. And now, two big maxi 33s of Pyromania, British imports. These are really cool. Def Leppard Photograph on one side, and side two, Bring It On, the Heartbreak, and Mirror Mirror. Check out, you can see kind of like Marilyn Monroe. Looks like a lady looking like Marilyn. There's a camera shutter photograph. This is a British maxi single. And another one from their first album, Bringing On That Farm, actually High and Dry, sorry, the first album, has Bringing On the Heartbreak, Me and My Wine, You Got Me Running. Man, this is another British import. It's a live shot of the Leps, you know, back in the day, Vertigo. Of course, I opened it, you know, of course, no vertical swirl, just a tiny bit one. But these are great albums, these two, Photograph from Pyromania. Man, great shape, dude. Vertigo, wow, 45 RPM.
See, you're right. They're 45 RPM, not 33s.
Wow, nice.
Okay,
and now Elvis.
Well, before Elvis, a real cool Italian pressing. This album is in great shape on Deja Vu Records. This must have come out in the 80s. It's Marilyn Monroe songs. There's 20 songs. Look at that picture of Marilyn Monroe on the cover. 20 golden greats. Really, really cool, man. Printed in Italy. Okay, now on to the Elvis. Never had this one. I've seen it. RCA Camden, Special Records, Candlelight. Elvis, the greatest show on earth. Some good songs. I like Gentle in My Mind, The Impossible Dream, Something. Beatles song, Early Morning Rain. I mean, I know that all you Elvis guys, a shout out especially to Joel, for me, Johnny Cashman, thank you, my brother, doing much better. To Spellerine, love you, dude, also, thanks. All you guys out there, it's great. And now what I'm gonna show you is another album, which is The Legend Lives On. This is a Canadian album, I think this is actually a bootleg. The Legend Lives On. I think, Dr. Spellerine, you have this album, and you have the insert which has all the Burbank concert. You have all these records because you're up in Canada. Now I didn't see this. So I know it's a bootleg because it's not done by RCA or anybody, but it's a great bootleg. And Spellerine, I know you have this, so for you this is not a surprise. But look how cool this is in the original gatefold. It has the 68 comeback. It was Percy Dorsey shows from the Waist Up LP. I think you have a majority of these. I remember distinctly seeing the Burbank one. And I love this cover, dude. Elvis Presley, here's a picture of them. Elvis Presley stereo. This is really cool. Elvis Presley Legend is a Canadian bootleg copy. Huh, cool. Now, imagine how cool this is. I never expected that I would get this record. And actually, just to let you guys know, I have 6 Russian imports. I have about 3 or 4. Korean, South Korean records. Funnily, out of all my records, I never had a Japanese pressing here. I never had a Japanese pressing, and my first Japanese pressing is actually Moody Blue by Elvis, so it's cool to have him as the Japanese pressing. There it is. Got this for $15, $1.5, just what you know. Not in Gary's store. Oh yeah, yeah. And it's a black vinyl, of course. I mean, this is really cool. It's got the, you know, the English version of the songs and the Japanese. You can't see it because it's a stupid ass camera. All you'll see, it says Moody Blue Elvis Presley. You won't even see it, but yeah, you'll see the Japanese writing there. There it is, it's in Japanese. Wow, and here's it in English, the other side of all the songs on Moody Blue. Elvis' last album. Really, really awesome. Wow. You know, it's a black vinyl. So I know that's a sought after one. I don't know. I'm assuming in Japan they made a lot of the black vinyls. But here in the US, the common one, as you guys know, is the blue one, which the majority of us who collect Elvis have the blue one. Well, if you collect a lot of Elvis, you have the blue one. Spellerine, I know you have both copies, blue and the black one as well. And I think Johnny Cash fan. Also, but this is a freaking good one to get. Amazing. This one and the Canadian bootleg, Elvis the Legend Lives On, are amazing. You can tell it was pressed really good. It has a 10 song. The other side, of course, has also the... So this is a Japanese Elvis. Wow, nice. So guys, I hope you enjoyed my collection. Some interesting and good stuff. Half of it was Elvis, some Roy Orbison. And shout out once again to the U.S. Love you, man. I'm glad you're happy birthday to all of us here. Happy birthday, USA. To all the friends, Spellerine, Rob, you're a big Elvis fan. You saw Elvis in concert. Man, that's a thrill. Whoever else did also see Elvis, you know, God bless. Johnny Cash fan, you're Joel, thank you. God bless you too. You're a brother, as is Spellerine and Rob, and Craig in Canada, and you're a brother too. Hopefully one day I'll get up to Canada and to Boston. You know, love to visit Canada, and it's a beautiful country. So, and love your Canadian pressings as well. Of Canadian records. I do have Canadian records, that's the thing. More than Russian and Korean and Japanese combined. Canadian records, I know I have a good fair share of pressings.
Elvis, mainly Yardbirds and other albums that are Canadian, which I love. The Beatles, that Touch of Pepper Mono Canadian is just unbelievable. All right, guys, love you. Hope you have a great, great, great 4th of July. And to all you non-USA brothers and sisters in the VC community, peace as well. Love y'all, Derek. Man, watch your videos. Love it. You too. Have a great one. All right. And you're all too hard to name, too many to name. But love y'all. Peace. Have a happy 4th. I hope you enjoyed these albums I got.